Violence prevention, the bill to expand a shock trauma program, how it could save lives. Hello, everyone. Thanks for staying with WJZ. I'm Vic Carter.
And I'm Denise Koch. Well, shock trauma does more than save the lives of victims of violence.
A unique program works to keep them safe from future attacks. Alex Demetrik reports the program could spread nationally in a bill headed for Congress.
Not everyone gunned down in Baltimore is a deliberate target. Sometimes the wrong person is attacked. Keith Breeden was shot because he was driving the same kind of car a man targeted for murder was driving.
At that minute, my life changed forever after 45 years of living in and around the city.
Staff at the University of Maryland's Shock Trauma Center saved Breeden's life. Violence all too often brings people here.
Anybody that thinks that the violence is not a huge issue in Baltimore is nuts.
At Shock Trauma, a victim saved once is at increased risk of being attacked again. So the center developed a program to reduce that risk. Recovering patients are something of a captive audience, giving program workers an opportunity to offer help.
Receive a bedside evaluation for needs ranging from groceries to bus money, and the program connect to patients with job training, housing support, and substance abuse.
For me, it was just a change in address, and then the help with, you know, setting up a place that I could maintain on my own.
Maryland Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger is making it the model of a violence prevention bill. It would take what Shock Trauma is doing and fund similar programs at other hospitals around the country. For Keith Breeden, who was left disabled by the shooting, the program helped during and after his time here.
That was the biggest help for me, that I wasn't by myself.
Not when he came in, and not when he left. Alex Demetrik, WJZ.